are saying that Kamala Harris is a DEI hire, you know, diversity, equity, and inclusion, that she's had everything handed to her because she's a woman, because she's black, because she's Southeast Asian, because she's whatever. If we're going to talk about DEI hires, why don't we talk about JD Vance? You know why JD Vance became Hollywood liberal and Hollywood darling and CNN contributor and all of those things? Because he supposedly was the translator for hillbillies, hillbilly elegy. Right? So that was his entree, his diversity, equity, and inclusion. So let's include hillbillies and diversity, equity, and inclusion, or is it just for black people and Latinos?
I really don't think that I care to hear the analysis of an Ozempic shooting gold digger who's putting down a swath of the nation. And you can cut that one, because that's exactly what it is. That was Anna Navarro, who somehow lucked onto The View. Look, you want to be mean, I'll be mean, and I'm going to be better at it. And I don't want to have to do this, but that really pissed me off to sit here and be like, oh, he's a DEI hire. He actually went and got a law degree, and he also served his nation in uniform, which, you know, Kamala Harris, you know, Hucktaw 2024, everybody's saying that now. It was Kane's original. That, you know, she didn't do any of that. But Anna Navarro, by the way, and yes, an Ozempic shooting gold digger. I'm you can quote me six ways to Sunday on that. Happy to say it over and over again, because it's exactly what it is. If you're going to go after, you know, a giant section of the country and try to mock, you know, people as hillbillies and act like JD Vance is some sort of like hillbilly whisperer, then I'm absolutely going to talk about your skinny in a shot and the fact that you went and chased money in South Florida. But, you know, whatever. Hey, I'm tired of this. Anna Navarro was a nobody when she was on Fox. I remember coming up in the industry, and she's older than I am. And I remember coming up in the industry, and she just was really milquetoast. Nobody really paid attention to anything that she wrote. Nobody paid attention to anything that she said. She really didn't have any style. She really didn't, you know, she just sort of said the same thing that everyone else said, but always like a couple of days after everybody else already said it. And, you know, when you're, you know, milquetoast like that and not very original and not fast on your feet, you don't go very far in commentary, and you definitely don't go very far in broadcasting. So her trade is cosplaying as a Republican on a very far left Marxist television show. And that's the only value that she brings to the table. She acts like she is a Republican. And I guarantee you that this would never happen if she actually were a Republican, because they go at you when you're, I've guest hosted that show before. I mean, they make it, I've had a friend who is legitimately way more Republican than any of the women who say that they are now on that program. And they made her life a living hell. So you have to completely, you have to assimilate like the Borg and in order for them to accept you and to make your life easy on that program. And she wanted to take an easy check. So she decided that's the route that she's going to go. But I'm going to tell you something. At least people who live in Appalachia, or people who live like in my third book, Flyover Nation, people who live in, you know, the Midwest or in the Ozarks, etc., they're honest about what they believe and about what they do. And they're not going to sit here and sell out for a paycheck and cosplay as something that they aren't, you know, and live this very, you know, shallow, materialistic, unfulfilling life so they can get clicks. That's not what they do. They actually live really rich lives. And so in some ways, I feel really sorry for her, because she ain't never met no hillbilly, number one. Those people are way more competent and way more self-sufficient than she is. And again, I just really have a problem with accepting any kind of serious, legitimate analysis from somebody who says something that everyone else was thinking and already saying 2 days later. You know, you're an Ozempic swilling gold digger. That's exactly what you are. And you're cosplaying as a Republican. And if you have a problem with me saying any of these things, you can fly your fat ass to Dallas and come and ask me about it. All right.
Happy Wednesday,
everybody. So I'm
out of give a damn juice today.
I am. Thank you. That's my inner monologue coming out right there. I get really aggravated when people go after Flyover Nation denizens, you know, because those people have been kicked around six ways to Sunday. You know, in my third book, I went and I was looking at, where do all the people who wear the uniform come from? Where do all the people who enlist come from? They come from all the places that the coastal elites like to mock. They come from those places. You know, and if it wasn't for those folks that y'all on the coastal elites, that all those people mock and laugh at and talk smack about and say he's a DEI hire, because, I mean, that's not even in any ways original. Actually, I read it somewhere else first. I think she just repeated something that I've seen already. I actually read something like that a couple of days ago on social media. Like, at least be original. Oh my gosh, if you're going to insult someone, like, at least acknowledge the tweet that you stole. But I'm so tired of these people getting kicked around and smacked around simply because they don't live shallow materialistic lives like people on the coasts, like these progressive elites on the coast do. I get so tired of this stuff. You know, I mean, the nicest people that I've ever met are those folks. I mean, my family comes from those folks. My family's from the Ozarks. You know, Kane's family is, you know, he comes from, you got a lot of family out in rural Illinois. We got a lot of listeners all over the country. We got a lot of listeners that are stuck with the coastal elites, and they're holding it up and doing the best that they can in some of these cities on the West and East Coast. But I'm so tired of it. We're not going to revive that now. Kamala Harris, when the press tells you not to talk about something, that means you should talk about something. Kamala Harris, you don't even really need to bring up the fact that she's a DEI hire. You know what? Poop Booty Juice is too. He got hired because he's gay. That's why he got hired. He got hired because he likes to have sex with dudes. Kamala Harris got her career started under Willie Brown. Like, literally. It's not an exaggeration. Again, I'm just the messenger. Go and talk to the Associated Press if you have a problem with it. But that's how she got her start. She started her career that way. And all of that information came from other Democrats in California. So get mad at those people for letting all of that information come out in the first place. She has not done anything except jail minorities, prosecute people who busted Planned Parenthood for selling baby parts, and being a horrific border czar, which the media is now trying to say that she's not. Americans are frustrated by a stalling economy, inflation, endless wars, the relentless assault on our values. But thankfully, there are companies like Patriot Mobile that still believe in America and the Constitution. And I'm proud to partner with Patriot Mobile because they're on the front lines fighting for the First and Second Amendments, sanctity of life, and our military and first responder heroes. Take a stand for conservative causes and put America first by switching to Patriot Mobile. You'll get the same nationwide coverage as the big providers because Patriot Mobile operates across all three major networks. Plus, they back their service with a coverage guarantee. Their 100% U.S.-based customer service team will find the best plan for your needs. Keep your number, keep your phone, or upgrade. The choice is yours. Visit patriotmobile.com/Dana or call 972-PATRIOT. And right now, get a free month when you use the offer code Dana. Don't be fooled by other providers pretending to share your values or have the same coverage. Switch to America's only Christian conservative wireless provider, Patriot Mobile. Visit patriotmobile.com/Dana today or call 972-PATRIOT for your free month of service. I saw this piece, Axios, who was one of the original, it was Axios and I think The Guardian and Politico, or somebody telling Politico, oh, Kamala Harris is never borders are. That's a whole thing that the right created. Axios actually had to, in the past hour, they had to revise their story. They put at the bottom of their story, and this is so rich, they put this, because they had a little correction. They had there that this article has been updated and clarified to note that Axios was among the news outlets that incorrectly labeled Harris a border czar back in 2021. That's a pretty big correction, don't you think so? I mean, that's a significant correction. I mean, these people are not serious. And then they tweeted. They finally had to tweet. Yes, you know, they because they had initially put. Harris border confusion haunts her new campaign. And they had written the Trump campaign and Republicans have tagged Harris repeatedly with the border czar title, which she never actually had. Oh my gosh, we're not. Can you play that? What's audio is that again? Audio soundbite 25. Just when they start, just when Biden says she's border czar, because this is where that phrasing came from. Listen.
I've asked her, the VP today, because she's the most qualified person to do it, to lead our efforts with Mexico and the Northern Triangle. And the countries we're going to need help in stemming the movement of so many folks, stemming the migration to our southern border.
Border czar. She's the border czar. That's where it came from. He did it. And so everyone began calling her, oh, border czar, border czar, border czar. That's what she is, yeah. Border czar. She's the border czar. Okay. Well, that's where it came from. And she made trips to the border. She made a trip to the border. She went, remember when, oh, where's the story at? This came from New York Post. New York Post has a story. Remember when she did her one trip to the border? And it was in El Paso where they built the wall? So guess what? They had federal agents cleared all of the people who entered illegally. They call them migrants on Fox, but it's illegal immigrants. They all the people who entered illegally and were sleeping out on the street. The federal agents were, according to New York Post and Border Patrol, they sent federal agents. They cleared all of the illegal immigrants off of the street. They got everything cleaned up as a show for Harris for her only trip to the border. Her first and only trip to the border. They had to sanitize the entire area. They even, get this, and this is per a number of Border Patrol and a lot of people live in El Paso. They were braiding the hair of the kids who were brought over illegally by the coyotes. They were cleaning everything up to make it look like, oh, nothing's here. Look at this. Because they knew all the press was going to be coming with her. All the press was going to be coming with her. And so they decided, okay, we're just going to clean it all up. And we'll get it all set. The media shows up. Nothing's wrong here. Look how great it is. Nothing's wrong. This is totally great. There's no problem at the border. They put people in holding facilities. They staged like a Broadway show called There's No Illegal Immigrants Here. That's what the show was called. Kane, did you see it? No. The show There's No Illegal Immigrants Here? Big show put on by federal agents and Vice President Border Czar Kamala Harris. Mm-hmm. One agent said, quote, they rented out a ton of hotels and we spent hours moving people. The kids that remained, we had to braid their hair. They made jokes about how the building was more secure than the whole border was, end quote. Another agent, quote, she had zero interest in seeing anything and it was very rushed, end quote. It was a whole show. It was a whole show. Another agent came forward, quote, we sanitized all the aliens out there to make it look good. That was one. There's like a ton of agents that have been speaking out. Another said they did a cleanup on the streets and all the people that they were releasing, they put them in hotels. They had a stash house. Border Patrol agents were at a stash house where 35 illegal immigrants were stored. I don't know how else you put it. And they were clearing them out 3 days after Harris visited. Now, if you think, well, maybe there weren't that many people at the border at that particular time. No, no, no. In June of 2021 alone, when she made her trip, border agents, this does not include gotaways, border agents stopped approximately 21,500 people for that month alone and only in El Paso. That was just in that area, right where Harris went to speak for that month alone. It does not include gotaways. Department of Homeland Security, interestingly, had no comment when they were reached for a response on that story. Now, remember, after she gave her don't come here speech, you had 8 million people that crossed over illegally. She went to one part of the border where they cleaned it up, and then she didn't want to look at anything. The media went and got photos of clean streets, etc., and then that was it. That was all it was. And then they got to say there's nothing wrong here. That's why they always go to El Paso, because they just get it cleaned up. They actually have a force multiplier there in terms of a physical structure called a wall. But the media is all in on making sure you don't call her a border czar. And they're trying to tell you, you can't bring up, if you do, I think half and half they're trying to say, they're trying to bait Republicans into using DEI attacks. But you know, DEI attacks is not an attack on identity. It's an attack on the fact that her identity was treated as merit by itself. That somehow things over which you have zero control are the greatest measure as to whether or not you can do a specific task. That is stupid. But yet that's what the left promotes. And then they tell you if you point out that they promote and they advance because of that, then that's somehow bad. It's an acknowledgement of the truth of this situation. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.